Alright, so we're going to go ahead and try the cutscene percent new category that we're trying to make a thing. If we keep saying it, that makes it a thing, right? So in this category, we're going to be watching every single cutscene, not skipping a single one, and playing through the game, also including Cop Rock, which is the boss fight where you fight against the cop and he wants to dance on your grave, so you have a literal dance battle with him. As you can tell, there's also music to the game. We have the music playing, so this is going to be a speedy slow run. Nonetheless, be safe, have fun, eat brains. We're starting the run in 3, 2, 1, go. For the extent of this run, I'm also not going to talk through the majority of these cutscenes. They're new to me for the most part as well.
Dateline, Pennsylvania, where one city has entered the 21st century 50 years ahead of schedule. Welcome to Punch Bowl, a city built for the space age. Here in Punch Bowl, experimental science and state-of-the-art technology create a futuristic paradise the likes of which have never been seen. This is a city unlike any other, free of crime, pollution, poverty, and other urban blights. Menial labor is a thing of the past, thanks to all the robots who keep Punch Bowl running like clockwork. People can't stop talking about it, and why should they? Punch Bowl is a model of good old American ingenuity, much of it developed by famed scientist Dr. Herman Y., now a naturalized American citizen working for the good guys. But who's funding this fantastic foray into futurism? Why, none other than billionaire playboy industrialist Andrew Munday. America's favorite rags-to-riches story is the visionary who's calling the shots in this town. At the grand opening ceremony this morning, the world's richest man had this to say.
Here in Punch Bowl, for the first time in human history, life is what it was meant to be, free of all unpleasantness. Why, someday the entire world will be like Punch Bowl, but for now, it stands alone, a beacon of purity and human potential in a world of social upheaval and moral turpitude.
True.
Bold words from a bold man. But perhaps the only thing more unlikely than this orphan's rise to fame and fortune is the city he's built, where everyone is invited to drink their fill of the future, and no one has a care in the world.
Oh my goodness!
Who eats a hot dog like that?
Get your hands off my weenie!
Good morning. Is everything okay?
He stole my hot dog!
Well, that wasn't very nice. Stealing isn't allowed in Punch Bowl. You'll have to give it back. If you'd like something to eat, I can show you
one like of Punch Bowl's
many
solution.
Fine dining establishments.
Yeah, go eat something else, jerk. Go on, get out of here. He stole my hot dog.
There we go.
Oh, my goodness.
Perfect. So. Why? The rest of the game that's not cutscenes, I am going to talk and give a good description of the game as we go. Right off the jump, we stole this guy's hot dog. He's still pissed about it, so we need to kill him. We tell her she needs to go tell those police, and then we go talk to Guidebot here. Guidebot's going to give us a good tutorial, but we can't skip around her, unfortunately, no matter how we do these speedruns. But we can at least push this along.
I can tell by the look on your face, you're gonna love Punch Bowl. Follow me.
So we want to make a direct shot over to the cops over here. We found out that she just snitched on us, and you know what they say, snitches get stitches, so.
Good morning, officers.
Be quiet, Guidebot.
Right, this is a normally unskippable cutscene anyway.
But officer, we just started the tour.
But it's my favorite.
The tour's over. We don't
so
want
far.
A sick bum in an ugly tie walking around on opening day stinking up the place.
Nor do we actually want to touch that guy. Ugh.
Exactly. So we're just gonna stand here nice and quiet. And you are gonna get in the back of the squad car. And we'll all be happy.
And we'll all be happy.
We're waiting. Tap, tap, tap.
I guess you don't have any choice.
So with these guys, you just want to run right up behind them, press whatever your action key is, mine is X in this case, and then you want to go ahead and eat the brains. Right before you trigger Guidebot, which she gives you the green indicator to show you where she's going to be at, you want to jump, that way you get a little bit more distance, and then now you get introduced to your first real ability of the game, which is your fart.
Oh, I see.
luckily Stubbs has an awful diet of just eating brains and random parts of people that he kills, so obviously this is a foul bit of gas. When you fart on them, though, it makes them all instantly eatable. So then your other zombies can take out those guys, you get that, and then you're right over here.
Have you thought about changing your diet? You really should.
No. Screw you, Godbye.
Oh, we'll never get anywhere unless you push those fellas out of the way. Walk up behind one of them. Now give them a gentle... Wonderful!
Wonderful!
Why don't you call your new friends over? First, stand perfectly still and transfix them with your steely gaze. Now, purse those lips and whistle. Well done. They're heading right over.
And so at this point, Guidebot's going to give us one last lesson, and that's about our health bar. And then we'll be off to the races.
Now, we still have a lot to see.
Man, I've been told that. Even my coworkers that saw the run were telling me to do that. I'll submit it for the winter. Yeah, because I can't do SGDQ. But I can do AGDQ, possibly.
Then feel free to take a few seconds to relax and recuperate. You'll feel much better after a few deep...
Now that we've moved to Colorado, I don't know where the closest one is. It used to be the Virginia one. So at this point, we're still going to go through with our normal speedrun strategies. We're off to the races now. Be safe, have fun, and eat brains. That's the motto we got to live by. Or is it die by, since we're a zombie? Nonetheless, we're going to make a straight shot over to the monorail, and then we'll be greeted with, I believe, three real cutscenes and like half of a cutscene. The half one we can't skip anyway. But the three after that, we normally do skip, so they're all going to be relatively new to me. I really haven't watched these cutscenes since the game was originally on the Xbox, and I rented this game from Blockbuster. What a time, what a time! If anything, the run feels more casual now, because I don't have to move up and like hit escape on the keyboard a bunch. Yeah, ride that monorail, Stubbs.
Hey, come back here!
Hey, come back here! Blockbuster! Blockbuster percent!
This is the chief! What the hell is going on out there? You would not believe the calls we're getting at the station! Help me! Help me! Something's trying to eat my brain! Sounds like a sick dog or something. You boys better lock things down pronto!
Why are his hands going off the sides of the watch thing that they have?
The monorail is arriving.
That was a cool cutscene. I like that.
Welcome to the Fertile Crescent Biome, where the grass is always green.
Maggie Monday.
Today at the world's most advanced greenhouse, meet me,
mi amor.
Maggie Monday.
Some folks go for cantaloupe.
Is everything satisfactory, Miss Monday?
Yes, Sonny.
Sure you don't need anything? A cold drink?
No.
A cigarette?
No.
Foot massage?
Oh, I'm... What?
No, nothing. Never mind.
You're a nice man, Mr. Skegness, but don't you have better things to do than make passes at your employer's mother?
I'm just doing my job, Miss Monday. Andrew asked me to look after you, and I'm going to make sure, nothing unseemly happens on this wonderful,
Sunny.
Fabulous,
Sunny.
Huge.
I think he does
eyes
as well.
Up here.
Day.
Oh, Jesus. Stubbs. No wonder they hate us.
Let her come with me, Miss Monday. This doesn't look like a safe place for you. Perhaps we can go back to my place.
Nice try, Mr. Skegness!
What a player. It's the police. Wow, the color filter change. So we're gonna get greeted with a couple tutorials up here, so we can just hit start on our controller, and that'll actually skip past it like that. Ultimately, our end goal is gonna be to come right up to this building on our right-hand side here, but first, we have to unlock it. They have a great security system that puts the unlock lever all the way over here. So hang it right at the mushrooms, come down the wooden alley, and you will see a vehicle coming up on the in front of us. Kill that thing. Woo! Oh god.
Skirt, skirt!
So now we want to just shamble our way downtown, running fast, and go up here and hit the button. That's going to unlock the door that we were just talking about. Ideally, we can get a good jump. Aw, I didn't go forward enough. If you can land properly, you'll hit that slope and it'll let you start running down it instead of hitting a landing animation. Not that it saves a boatload of time, but time save is time save, and we want to go fast, so. Just clobber these police guys. We're going to get another tutorial prompt up here in a moment. For whatever reason, it doesn't think we know how to drive this vehicle yet. There we go. Strike! Bowling strike. This was baseball, that was a home run. So up here we have another cutscene. Let's see what we got. Oh, that's really not as crazy as I thought it would be. So around here we just need to bob and weave, bob and weave. Here. Jump. Guidebot.
Why, hello there. It's me, Guidebot. Remember me from the plaza? Are you sure that
now we're gonna get
your
introduced
doesn't bother
to
you?
The gut grenade.
Because it bothers me. I can see all those internal organs slurping around in there.
This ability is essential. It's the bread and butter of how we can route through most of this game in the tricky areas that we do have. So, oh man, not the best. But what you want to do there is jump, so that way the tutorial prompt is happening while you're in air or landing. That way you don't lose any momentum or speed. We want to maintain line of sight here because that'll bring all these guys out. They're like, where is Stubbs? Where's that damn zombie? Pull them all out, and then you can run right in. Much easier. Get him to come out, juke him. Broke your ankles. Then we come right around here. This cop walked up perfectly for us to walk around. And then at this point, we're just gonna run right through here. Again, we wanna maintain line of sight. As long as we know where to go, we can get these guys to funnel out. This scientist is such a pain, so we gotta make sure he comes all the way out. And him coming out will bring these guys out. Thank you for that.
Cop rock soon,
Lesson 3. Oh no! Cop rock soon! It is soon. It's very soon. That did not go the way I wanted it to with the grenade. Made a whoopsie and threw it a little angled. That's weird. I feel like that's not a full cutscene, right? That didn't seem full. I didn't click anything. You guys saw my controller. As my controller, as my witness, I clicked nothing. So right around here, we just want to, again, make a direct shot over to where we need to be. I like going along this sidewall here and then cutting across at this point. That gives you the most line of sight and cover, so that way you don't take too much damage. Not usually a problem, but if it becomes a problem, it's very, very, it's a big issue. So you don't want to ever have to die right around this point. Pull that cop out, and then you can run in here. He comes out just enough to swing right through. Go right around that. And that guy got scared because the cop shot at him. Go figure, right? Naturally.
Hold it, Isle. Pay attention.
Oh man, that was clean. It looks like the Disney castle. I guess it's probably the town.
The dead walk. Oh, mighty voices in my head. I'll never doubt you again. The commies have infiltrated this country so completely that even the dead have turned against us. Well, the Quaker State Irregulars ain't go without a fight.
Yo. That's funny. The Quaker State Irregulars.
Good morning, officers.
Good morning, Pumper.
Killer up?
Yeah, but make it snappy. We're in the middle of a zombie holocaust.
Okie dokie, one tank of extra leaded coming right up.
Zombie holocaust?
I'm not sure I have enough cash to cover.
Oh, never you mind, sir. It's on the house.
Oh, there's no need for that.
Oh, it's my pleasure, officers. My pleasure. Want me to look under the hood?
No! I need to use the restroom.
Oh, it's around the back.
Yeah, go ahead. I'll try to keep from eloping with the car.
Boy, you know, it's a good thing you stopped by, officer. There's been a bit of lawlessness this afternoon.
Yo.
Strangest thing, this gentleman, a very ill one by the look of it.
Wait a minute. Green skin, festering wound in his guts, ugly tie.
I'm never gonna get used to seeing that. Huh. Ain't that a kick in the head?
Damn, I thought I was a good guy. I wasn't killing people like this. True stuff. And away we go. Yeah, this is a crazy long cutscene. Wait, he goes in on purpose?
Okay, everyone turn to the right.
Alright, so now it's back to regular run concept. So after normally that's all skippable. That's really interesting that I run in there. But we gotta get past these cops, and we have to conserve our grenades because we're gonna need them a little later. Once we get into this gauntlet portion. So we have to go right around this corner, straight up through to the red room, and then once we're in the red room, go straight forward to the room with the star on it. Granted, they all have stars, so go forward. Wow. And then left in the conference room, and right in the next room, because you'll be in the shower, and that'll take you right to where you need to be. At this point, we're still making good time, because that guy wasn't around the corner, and this door wasn't open. Perfect. So we jump through here,
we have a
and another
red situation. There is a zombie in the police station. Repeat, zombie in the police station. I'd like to encourage you all to shoot first and ask no questions whatsoever. Repeat, ask no questions. Just kill it. Masters,
so here I like to start off with the fart right in the beginning, and then run through and eat all the brains that you can manage to get to, because that'll make a couple of zombies for you, and you'll recharge most of your fart. And then here you just want to keep going, and once you kill enough cops, it seems to get you to the point where they open up the door. They just want to make sure you're serious about it, so you gotta take out a few guys. Come on, open up. I want through. There we go. Get me out of here. There we go.
Got one over here.
Alright, I've never seen this next cutscene, or haven't seen it in a long time, rather.
Listen up, you brain-eating cretin! Your little cannibal joyride is over! My men are cleaning the rest of the zombie filth off the streets! And as for you, I'm gonna fix your wagon personally! Dr. Y is on his way over right now, but I'll be dancing on your grave long before he arrives! I wonder if there'll be anything left for him to dissect!
We can't let those thugs destroy such a fascinating and potentially useful specimen.
Not to worry, old chap. We'll do it ourselves. Where's the bone saw?
I thought you had it.
Do it. Alright, so now, like in the regular run, we run up here. And now that we're in the duct system, we're gonna go up this chute and then hang a left at our first opportunity. Our goal here is going to be to free Stubbs from the crazy scientists. And to do that, we gotta go down here. Oh shit, storm's rolling in. That was wild. Did you guys hear that thunder? Nonetheless, we gotta drop down here and then jump. Perfect. So for whatever reason, this cop feels like his best way to help in this situation is to free the prisoner. I don't agree, but he did it. So we run all the way down here, and we gotta go free ourselves. Joel, what do you mean by a master's out? And go in here, and now a cutscene. And I don't know. Yo, Stubbs is a thug.
I'm going to research this further.
I'll beat you down.
Gotcha.
Nobody escapes the stick.
These characters have such a personality. Alright, so now that we're through, you want to maintain a right-hand side for most of this. Because doing that lets you get past all those SWAT people, and then here you just adapt accordingly. If you see them all on one side, you don't go to that side, obviously. So now at this point, we cut over here. Nice! Oh no, he didn't move. I thought he was going to move perfectly and he stopped. And then we run right down the line. Hopefully we can play a game of chicken with this guy. Perfect. So, the way we do this in the non-cheat percent routing of the game is run all the way to the end here, and then we play shooting gallery.
Yikes! I'm bringing you.
Pay attention!
Pay attention! That's not the guy I thought I was gonna get. Luckily, auto-aim is in our favor. You ideally don't want to show around that corner, but... if you show around the corner, it can spawn more people, and I don't want that. Alright. Yeah, they really are. But this is Cop Rock. This is the dance-off.
I'm glad you came directly to my office. It's much more convenient if I kill you. You're about to learn you can't escape.
told you I would dance in your grave, and I meant it.
Oh. That thriller. Oh man, Stubbs got his boys. Mr. Sandman. Wait, what? Why didn't my controller pick it up? Okay. Try that again. Mr. Sandman, bring me a dream. Make her the cutest that I've ever seen. Give her the word that I'm not a rover. And tell her that her lots of knives are over. Sandman, I'm so alone. Don't have nobody to call. Hey. Red. Nice, there's a round two. Green, blue, red, yellow. Green, blue, red, yellow. Oh, I missed the blue. Green, blue, red, wait. Fuck. Blue, green, red, blue. Yellow, green. Oh, here we go. Crazy blue, blue, yellow, red. Yeah, the soundtrack for this game is phenomenal. Absolutely check it out on Spotify. Lollipop is great. I call her lollipop, lollipop, lollipop. Wait, what the fuck? Do I need to commit further? Oh no, I missed the first note. Huckleberry, cherry, lime. Ah! If you have blue, blue, choice, green, green. Be your pick. I don't understand what I'm messing up. Red, blue, blue. Sometimes it'll take it. Green, yellow, green, red. Double beats. Green, green, yellow. Oh, God. Green, green, or green, blue, green, green, yellow. Fuck! I don't think I can do that part because of the way it reads the controller. Oh my god. Blue, blue, red, red, yellow. Arrgh! Yellow, yellow, blue, blue, red. God damn.
That's like Shirley Temple.
Shit.
With her legs chopped off at the knees.
What? What? That's not right. Blue, blue, red, yellow. If you hit just one, it... Oh my gosh. For real, he's got moves. Damn it, I missed the yellow. not missing as many notes. It's gonna get so difficult now. God damn. I guess I gotta like hard commit to the direction. Shit. That's just flexing. Green, yellow. Oh, oh shit. It's red, yellow, green. Stubbs his head just like... Yo. It's like it's not taking my command. Can I use the D-pad? Probably not. I think if you do this on the legendary difficulty and perfect, it'll be, you get the bonus with Master Chief. Stubbs? Okay. That's it, I guess. I pass it anyway. Oh, does he have a gut grenade on his foot? He's got boogie fever.
Zombie.
I don't have to play fair.
No explanation for the massive explosion that destroyed the Punch Bowl police station or...
Oh, Fred. I think we're moving a little fast.
Relax, baby. Ted would have wanted it this way.
I watched him die.
Yeah,
that's the
like
snitch from earlier.
Hours ago. Don't live in the past, Judy. It's time to move on.
It's hard with the controller. For that dance
Fred,
moves, though.
Fred,
or those dance
Fred.
So now we're back to the regular game. Cop Rock was exciting, but very difficult, actually. Surprisingly, because the PC does not want to read the PC version of the game does not read the controls super accurately, so you can't do like the double tap. I imagine that was much easier on the actual Xbox. Nonetheless, we go through the parking garage up here, and we got to go all the way to the top, and then Gangbot is going to greet us and give us our last ability, which is going to be our gut grenade. I mean, not gut grenade. Head roll. And at this point, it's really just optimized movement. We're just running around, playing a game of chicken with some of these police officers, hoping that they don't block us too hard. But we just run all the way through. This part is kind of fun because sometimes that cop takes out all the police as he's driving through like a maniac. Ooh, Stubbs the cigarette is lit really bright right now. I feel like it's on a timer. I don't know why, and I don't know why today I've been noticing it more, but sometimes it's super bright.
Guess who? It's your old friend, Guidebot. How are you?
I'm good.
Things are rather hectic around here, aren't they?
Sure
Quite an
are.
Astonishing turn of events. You must feel like you're losing your head.
No, Guidebot. You get it because she gave us the ability to bowl our heads. She's crazy. So at this point, we just want to run all the way through to this elevator. And then that'll take us all the way down. Where's that gonna take us? To the guys that we need to kill in the loading area. Yep. The game feels so different just because of watching the cutscenes. I'm like, wait, where are we at? So, over at this point, we want to go over here, come in from the left-hand side, and then throw a gut grenade. Throw another one if you need to. You gotta kill all three of those guys and hopefully be like right around here. And the game will give you a save trigger eventually. When it wants to. I've had this go really quick and I've also had it take 15 seconds. There it is. That was very slow. Nonetheless, we go on.
What the hell is he yelling about?
So at this point, the game wants us to take a certain routing because it is relatively linear. But the thing is with that routing, it is a lot slower, like an extra 30 to 45 seconds. You don't get a cutscene out of it. It's just slower pathing. So to combat this, instead we just run this way. I'm going to run all the way through, not get hit by that cop car. I've learned the hard way that you need to look around that corner if you're going pretty fast. Because you do not want that to happen. You don't want to get clobbered by that car because it can instant kill you depending on where it hits you. So the game wants us to actually go in there. However, if we just go all the way forward, the cops eventually just give up. They keep running around us, but they don't expect us to be there for whatever reason. The game doesn't acknowledge you, which is in our favor. Oh, those guys did. This guy shouldn't. Now, once you get right around that bend, you gotta rip off your own head. And then you're good to go.
Join us! Take up arms and fight with the Quaker State Irregulars! We licked Hitler and we can lick the hordes of undead Reds! Now, who's with me?
Now that's a normal cutscene. All of this part's a regular cutscene. We are gonna see a couple, like three new ones coming up here in a moment.
I don't get it. That's because you're dumb, Jim. What was that?
Just gotta run on through. And then when we come up to these guys, get them all together. And you gotta take the first guy's arm for whatever reason. And then once you get all these guys down, you just run right for them all. Because luckily there's gonna be a patrol coming out here and we can skip it with what we call Quaker skip by running into this door. The load screen's gonna trigger here any moment. Once the game saves, essentially, it should trigger.
Welcome to the Punch Bowl Mall. Where your dollar goes farther.
Unfortunately, we only have two guts right now, so it's a slow kill on the boss. We're gonna have to farm and get a third real quick. No harm, no foul. That's really quick right up here, luckily.
Jeepers!
And then you have to turn right over to this person. That way you can get the second civilian. So that does a couple things for you. Primarily, it gets you the gut that you need for the quick kill, but then it also gets you the two bodyguards, so you don't have to worry about Stubbs getting beat to death while you're over here jumping around as a hand. So once you see those guys coming out of that door, you can freely go up and around, and that'll take you over to the boss. Mind you, we did none of this.
I'll be in the truck. You finish him all.
Storm's coming. I got a plate in my head. Come on. Give me that arm. And that's quick kill.
That numbskull's been in there too dang long. But he can hoof it back to the farm.
You guys, welcome to the Punch Bowl Mall. Your buck stops here. Come in.
Come on now.
Go, Stubbs, hop in the truck.
I know you won't fail me, old trusty iron steed.
He's gonna grab to the bottom. Hell yeah. Get it, Stubbs. Dang, with cutscenes, this is so much longer. This is like a movie. It's already been like 15 minutes of cutscenes, I think. Knob cheese farm. No gambit. That's how we get in. That's so good. Alright. So after that eventful cutscene, we get ourselves into the Knob cheese farm. And we want to go right through all the cornfields, because for whatever reason, their cheese farm has corn. Probably for government subsidies, who knows. But we're going to run through here. And I like staying on the edge of the scarecrow. Reason being is it doesn't seem to get you as much aggro from the people running out like this guy. But it's all a gamble. Once you go through that area, you want to go straight to the other side of this like ravine. And yeah, that's what it said on the sign, cheese farm. Like it's a dairy farm, right? Isn't that what that would be considered? Nonetheless. Yeehaw, partner. So we run through here. This guy's gonna shoot us right in the face, as you do. It is a zombie. You can't blame him. You want to diagonal jump so that you land on the slope, and that allows you to not have to worry about a landing animation. Stay along the edge here. There's gonna be a guy popping out right now. He tries to shoot. He scores. And we want to throw our gut down. Woohoo! First try. That jumps us over that. That way we don't have to go through all that mess. No, I didn't want to eat his brains.
Oh, God.
You gotta find some other way. All right, let's see if we can get the goalposts. Nope. So right over here, I like to drive the tractor right up this ridge. And then you can come right over to the side here, and there's a parking spot, conveniently. So Stubbs did not jump off of that properly. I don't know what happened there. And now we just run all the way forward. I'm not sure what to guess for the time estimate on this run at this point, because the cutscenes already have added a fair bit of time. My initial guess was about an hour and 20 to an hour and 30. 10 minute swing is what I'm thinking. first guess was an hour and a half, to be fair. I'm just now thinking an hour 20 to an hour 30. So now you go running through to the Otis farm, and you're going all the way down this side. Luckily, that guy's a scared little farmer with a musket. So you just run right past him, screw him. Oh wow, he spawned really early. Normally that guy doesn't spawn until right around here. Nonetheless, we run past him, go up these stairs. I feel like if you come in on stairs at an angle in this game, you actually save your momentum.
Gonna bounce you good!
Dang nabbit! Kill that zombie! I want him dead! I want him more than dead! I want him so dead, the vultures won't touch him! Ain't I taught you boys nothing?
Oh my.
Get out of my way! I wonder if there's cheat codes to like actually spawn the Warthog in this game, because it has apparently some of the assets from Halo. Well, it's all built on the Halo engine, but it has the assets and art from it somewhere in the game files. That'd be cool to find out. Get in a ghost.
I'll smack the taste out of your mouth.
Or a wraith. Bust through it. Cutscene.
Now just hold it right there. Ask it the Lord and he shall provide it. Well, the Lord done provideth me with enough of dry nitrotoluene to blast you all the way back to Moscow. Don't even try to run. You ain't getting away from me. No one gets away from Otis Monday. Not even you!
Hey there, fella. Long time, eh? Son of a bitch!
Sorry about that. I had to go to the bathroom so bad. Oh, this is the discovery of the family. Oh shit, we're all related. Of course.
Do you remember what you are supposed to do?
Yes. Drop the antibacterial solution in the main treatment basin and activate the agitators to ensure that the water supply is untainted.
Don't screw it up.
If you're so concerned, why don't you do it?
Try not to say that.
Stubbs riding in on a sheep is fantastic. Good sheep. Yeah, see, I'm like Stubbs. I had to pee, man.
Welcome to the Punch Bowl Dam.
Oh, that's a weird
our
cut.
Motto is,
okay.
Damn it.
So this area is where the game starts to get a little bit more challenging. At this point, we're going to be introduced to two new enemies, two variants of scientists, three if you count those little robots there. So we're going to get red laser beam scientists, which you'll see shooting at me shortly. They're the equivalent of police officers, just as scientists. They run away just as much, they shoot just as much, and honestly, they're really just as little of a problem. Now, the other group, though, that we'll see in this next room coming up is the green circle scientists. Those guys are a pain. They have knockback on their abilities, and they can really make it to where you have a bad time. So at this point, we want to run forward, ideally not getting too much knockback. If they push us forward like that, awesome. Don't count on it, though. I'm going to run here, stick along to the side that they don't seem to be running, and just go right past them. Oh no, push me forward. Thank you. One more. Another? No. So, going through here. Nice.
Bloody hell. Now, what does a bloody blue screen mean? Does anyone know? Bugger off, I'm working. Look, if I don't get this bloody antibacterial solution in the bloody treatment basin, some zombie could just walk up here, have a wee, and then we're all done for as soon as tea time rolls around.
Thanks, mister. Alright, so let's try and get around Kevin the scientist. So you come over here, you throw your hand, notice Kevin standing right in the center like a jerk. Jump right over that. Sometimes Stubbs flips you off like that. You just gotta roll with it. Perfect. So this next area, we gotta make sure we do a couple of things. We're gonna first make sure we pee into all the clean water supply, because screw these people. At the 25% mark, we need to turn around and throw a grenade, because there's gonna be a green circle scientist that's gonna try and hurt us. And if they push us into the water, it's about a 30 to 40 second time loss. Feels bad. Don't want that. And then we also need to make sure we eat one scientist, which
Warning.
Will probably be the guy that's
going
to come
contamination
up in front of
detected.
Us here.
Isolate and remove contaminants immediately.
All those things happen for a reason, and that's all optimized for the sake of routing.
Contamination level at 25%.
Perfect. So now we get one zombie on our squad. We have that guy with the knockback dead, so we don't have to worry about him. And then, after that, we also get the hand. The hand is important because in the next area, after we do another gauntlet run, we're going to have to throw our hand and unlock a few areas.
Unacceptable filth level.
And use our hand to optimize the movement. So having the hand now saves us time later. And yes, Stubbs is taking the longest pee break.
Contamination level at 75%. Total
pollution
imminent.
Once you hear the 75% mark, if you're at half health and not yellow, you're good. When you hear the critical, as long as you're not below your ankles, you're good. And that'll make more sense in a moment.
Contamination level critical.
We're fine.
Toxin detection system overload.
Good stuff. So after we do this gauntlet walk that we're coming up on, then we'll have the ability to use our hand again and like throw it and do the control mechanisms. Until then, we have to get through all these guys, which include the like Secret Service, I suppose. That's probably the best way to put these guys. The scientists. And a couple of new flying people, which we'll see coming up here. And the flying people come up in a moment, sorry. You can hear them. It's like the Secret Service, but given jetpacks. Get 'em, get 'em. So this is the area.
I
I've been missing that a lot lately. I need to practice. Oh no, I think I ran into the pole. Come on. The hand, like, sticks to everything. Sometimes the music breaks. So now we just go back to running as Stubbs. All the scientists are kind of confused. They're like, where the hell? What the hell? And then we just got to get around some green circle scientists. Push me. Thank you. Thank you. Need for Speed. Stubbs Edition.
Attention all dam personnel. We have worries. The power coil is overloaded. Make sure none of those things step inside the breaker boxes. If they overload the breakers, the entire dam could... Well, try not to think about it.
I wonder if that visual on the sides is because we have the widescreen fix implemented into the game so that it doesn't look all janky.
Is if they start walking between the breaker terminals and completing the circuit, and that's just insane. Oh no.
Oh no. Hop in. All right, so now we got to take our group of scientists up top here, making sure to kill all the other people that we see. Oh, it's raining in the game. That's cool. Perfect. Kill this guy. And then we want to go right here. And then the people are going to spawn right in front of us. Perfect. Oh man, that guy's attacking us off the jump. That's really good. Circuit. Electrocute? No. How is he flying through all of this and not dying? Perfect. He did. You did it, Stubbs. You did it.
Look, the dam!
This is Chuck Chumley of the Punch Bowl Action News. A breaking story from the Punch Bowl Dam, where the zombie who's been terrorizing the city is apparently cornered. Our roving reporter, Jimmy Nesbitt, is on the scene now and reporting live by telephone. Jimmy.
Oh God, help me! I don't want to die! Ah! appear to be experiencing some interference. Oh, I'm sure Jimmy will be back soon with his full report. This just in. Punchbowl Action News, your source for the news as it happens, has received a report of a 200-foot column of impressive water approaching the...
That's a cool cutscene. I like how it's just implied that you rode the tsunami. There's nothing that actually shows you riding a wave or how you survive.
I think it might be best if we all left town for a while until the authorities get things...
Ladies and gentlemen, Andrew Monday here. No, don't stand up. It's been a trying day. I want you all to know that I'm as shocked by these strange and terrible events as anyone, especially the flash flood, which has cost me millions in property damage.
Property damage? Andrew, how can you worry about that when people are dying?
I like how silencing her on TV is. I won't deny it's fine.
But Punchbowl will rise above these minor calamities. I invite everyone to calm down. Just take a deep breath and enjoy the rest of your day in Punchbowl. Everything is going to be fine.
I will. Good stuff, Stubbs. So we need to cut around here, and then in this area we're gonna kill two civilians coming up. That way we have enough for two gut grenades.
Oh God, not like this!
A wet burger, a wet weenie, a fountain of love, or a salty pickle. That's their whole menu. Tea time. Aww. A perfect jump gets you over that gap without touching the car. Will I save? That's cool. So what we want to do over here is just cut around, and you can jump that wall, but it is like a perfect series of events to get it, and it's very, very unlikely to do it very quickly. So what we do instead is just run over here, come up behind where their rocket launcher dude is,
to kill and to hear the lamentations of...
And then you kill him, because who needs him, right? You are going to need a little bit of health, but the game will save it here in a moment like that. You can wait just another moment and you're good. Then you jump just like that.
It's absolutely
his glasses
that you keep them out of the laboratory. This is the heart and soul of Punchbowl. All my stuff is in here.
Our orders are to secure the area using any and all means necessary, including, but not limited to, the wholesale destruction of said area.
Yes, about that. There's one of these things, it's wearing a really ugly tie. He could be quite useful as a specimen. You know, to prevent this sort of thing in the future.
I have my orders, sir. I'm not going to risk the lives of my men so you can play grab ass with the enemy. You want a sample? You can have whatever's left.
Imbecile.
So you can play grab ass with the enemies. No grab ass in here.
Lock and load, boys.
The cutscenes are fantastic. Honestly, this is a great choice. Thank you for recommending we do it today. Don't rock at me. Fuck! let this be a dream. It ain't.
Kill me! Someone, please! Kill
Charmin.
Me.
What are you rolling for, guy? Alright, so this is my regular strat for this area. What you do is you just kill out a route, basically, so that way you have a couple zombies to start, and they'll start cleaning house anyway. Auto aim is on your side, so always remember that. Because the game will not take whatever you want as your aim, it doesn't care. Gotta run over, this guy's a little out of range. Yeah, like, see, I didn't have to even face him. And so now I should have a little army. Yep. I found if I do this a little bit more efficiently, it hurts. Like, the game does not actually go properly. I just gotta make sure the zombies can keep on chugging. Fire into the military in the crowd. Do we have reinforcements on this side? No. Reinforcements there? No. Just on the back. There's a couple civilians, but that's not really an impedance. And these guys are all knocking on the door, so it should fall pretty soon. It's been about long enough. There we go. With the wall.
Catastrophic power grid failure.
That's how you get in there, as a tank blows up a wall.
Switch to fail-safe power cells.
Oh my gosh. That is probably how it would happen.
As long as you are here, the army will blow the whole place to pieces just to get at you. I will make you a deal. Make it to my private lab without destroying everything. I would be willing to.
All right. So you need to throw your bombs up here, kill all those guys, and that should open up this door. Perfect. And now we just gotta follow the green arrows. Green means go. That's all we gotta remember. Oh man, that went well. That's usually a really hard spot because there's two green circle scientists and they can really mess your day up. So right around here we just need to bob and weave. Get these guys out of our way. That was a slip up. I don't want any punch. And we're gone. So we run over here. This is a straight shot. The next area is kind of questionable. I suppose there is a cash strat. I don't really know how it works. Because sometimes that's already open without having to worry about the crazy scientist. But what you want to do is weave around him, ideally not hitting him. Because if he's alive, he'll then shoot that. And then when you activate the robots, as you see, they start attacking him. And that's pretty perfect. Whoopsie. Jump over this debris. We're honestly following that guy's wishes. We're doing very no damage to this business or to his lab. All his people are, but that's not me. I'm just getting through. You know? I'm doing me.
Refute this! Time for some
Don't eat me! No!
So ideally here we want to get one of the circle signs to us. And the best way to do that is to make them spawn pretty quickly.
I think you have no money.
That was close.
Fight it.
This gun rips. It's so ridiculous. That's pretty much the ideal way to do that in the non-cutscene route too.
Activate force field.
Now that I have captured the Alpha Zombie, I'm on the verge of the greatest scientific breakthrough in human history. I have been studying your tissue sample.
Oh, get to the bloody point already.
Your reanimation is the result of a catalytic reaction with a grass fertilizer I developed for Punch Bowl. I can see this is wasted on you. No matter. Soon you will be on the slab providing raw material for my greatest experiment.
His audio is super low.
Obviously, there are still a few bugs to work out, which is why we need to start dissecting you immediately.
Ooh, jolly good, let's go.
I did as you requested. You need to make sure you eat citizens in between here and there because you take a fair bit of damage from this guy's laser beams.
Warning,
especially if they push you back into a bad area. Alright, so that's round two. Can I just heal normal?
Yes. Energy levels normalized. All systems go. Resume cloning process. Warning. Energy levels critical. System will shut down.
I wish these buttons would turn green when you press them. That way you had a better indicator. Alright, so that should be the boss.
I hope you like the taste of formaldehyde, because you're going to be swimming in it.
Hey,
Hey, what's a pup bot gotta do to get a little action around here?
Why is there a pump bot there?
Hey, sweet cheeks, back that thing up. Yeah, I'm talking to you. Come on back here. Don't go away. Don't leave. Don't walk away, man. Come
walk
on,
away,
I'm
man.
Talking to you. Back. Come on over here. For crying out loud, you little tease. I kind of love you, and I think you're kind of get. Hey, where are you going?
Wait, did the military guy not spawn? I've made it through that before without the cheat codes, but I guess I won't. Alright, we're hoofing it from here. That's unfortunate. Yeah, the game definitely changes the tones, the colors, the whole atmosphere as you progress, and I really do like that. Damn, I landed on a flat surface of a bumpy surface. That's unfortunate. And the developers were talking about how they liked how they put the game as all taking place within a day, or the opening day of the town. So it makes it pretty cool. I do think this will have to be my last run. This storm sounds like it's kicking up a fair bit. But I'll definitely be on tomorrow as well. So if you guys have anybody in mind that you'd like me to turn it over to for after the stream, let me know. That should be good. I'd say we probably have like 10 to 15 minutes left. I'm really not certain, but I'm just kind of guessing. So now at this point, it's kind of a home stretch. So, again, I really do like going over to this side. I feel like it's not necessarily better or worse, it just seems like you can avoid a bit more shots, because when you go around on that side, you end up walking right into two officers or two military guys. So this avoids some damage and allows you to heal. Not that you really need it, but it's nice to have and not worry about your health. It seems like it's like 30 minutes longer, yeah. That's kind of wild, isn't it? 30 minutes of cutscenes. There's already a fair number of cutscenes in the main game. Like, or in the main speedrun that we can't skip. Definitely makes the game feel more complete, though. Obviously. It's always better that way. And see, this is how the Jeep is supposed to spawn. In an earlier run, oh shit. In an earlier run, it did not spawn properly. But yeah, like, give or take 30 minutes of cutscenes. But now is the best music in the entire game.
Smoke, grim and grisly, that's how you're going to die. No quick and painless end for you. It's gonna hurt. You're gone.
The party will start when we tear your heart and flay your flesh to ribbon. We'll break all your bones, we'll stomp on your stones and feed them.
Everything is as trouble as myself.
Jumping up that was pretty speedy, instead of taking the stopping motion.
I'll show you security!
So on this point, we just want to jump over and fart on them. Classic maneuver. It really is. It's a great song.
My arm! My
Stop brain. Eating that brain! Nope. Final boss cutscene.
Thank you so much. Have a lovely day. Well, look who's come crawling back, Mr. I don't need a guide bot. I'm just going to run around eating brains so guide bot gets stuck answering phones. I was just chatting about you with the central computer for the U.S. military. Apparently there's an airstrike on the way, but I'm sure that wouldn't interest you. I'm heading out now. Beat the rush, you know. Would you be a dear and tell Mr. Monday he's got 5 minutes before the whole town goes up in smoke? Thank you so much. Don't hurt me. Don't eat my brain. It's all I've got. Help. Nose! That tie!
Mother! Get back! That thing has destroyed my whole city, and I won't let him do the same to you!
Don't do this, Andrew!
Oh, man.
Get out of the way, Mother!
Stunning revelation.
I love that zombie!
Excuse me?
It was a hot summer night in 1933. I was just a girl. Yes? He was quite a man. I couldn't resist his charms. Everything was real sweet. Until
Dad came home.
He dragged my little Eddie out, and that was the last I saw of him. Until now. Father never told me what happened to him. Months later, I had a little something to remember him by.
Are you telling me my daddy was a traveling salesman who eats brains?
Oh, Andrew, try not to be such a pain.
That's where he stores them? Gross. beautiful. Huh.
You destroyed my city. You killed my family. And now I suppose you want to kill me. Well, go ahead. Go ahead and try. Damn.
Andrew Monday, we really just need to take down his shield, and the fastest way to do that is through gut grenades. Unfortunately, you don't have an unlimited source of them here, so you gotta pick and choose your battles. But by farming in between, you also have the opportunity to get charged up for the zombie head roll, which having another one is very good for a speed purpose. Oh shit. That killed him. So that's where you would end the speed run. GG. Sub 130. Sub 127, actually, yeah, that's more appropriate. Next time, 125. I gotta submit some categories now. Cheat percent and cutscene percent. This is what I would want to make in a 2D art piece. The end. Woohoo! Cutscene percent.
It was a pleasure to watch. Thanks, dude.
That was awesome. I've never been I appreciate to Paris. It a bit. I've never I really been do. To Rome. That was a fun one. The outside world's not what I'm thinking of. That's cool. That was definitely a very satisfying run. Even with all the cutscenes, it's hour 26 and a half. Punch bowls where that's not bad. I want
to fall in love. To fall in love. Friends will talk of travel talk and places that they've been.
I try to
I act as if I care to be polite.
I wonder if they'll ever
I wonder yeah, if like they'll ever know the wonders that I've seen in Punch Bowl where my lover keeps me warm at night. You can feel
I'm gonna look
the
outside
magic
in a minute and see how the storm is doing. It's pretty wild
street.
Outside right now, it sounds
the
like.
The smiles of cheer that will appear on everyone you meet. When everything is automatic,
I think it's fitting to have the credits involved.
Always find yourself
all of that
ecstatic.
For the cutscene percent.
Then true love will make your life complete. Don't ask me if I'm staying. I never want to leave.
This city's
built to fit me like a glove.
Now every day's a holiday.
Each night is New Year's Eve. Cause
you
Punch
know.
Bowl's where I want to fall
Actually,
in love. To fall in love. Cause Punch Bowl's where I want to fall in love. To fall in love.
Music plays out. I just want to thank everybody for stopping in and watching this. An hour, 26 minutes, 29 seconds, 63 milliseconds. That went through very smoothly. even as we played through, I don't think we had any detrimental speed logs. Like in a real run, cutting out those cutscenes, I think we had a legit run. We had a really good speed to it. But it's really cool. And seeing the story was really neat. Finding out that it's all the family. I've read the wiki, but seeing it makes more sense than just reading it. Definitely a fun experience. I enjoyed this. I enjoyed playing the cutscene percent. So I hope you enjoyed watching it. We'll let the music kind of fade out at this point. So it'll do its thing in a couple of minutes.